Hello. Welcome to yoga. My name is Nicola. As always, this is an all levels yoga practice. I always offer several options and modifications, but I just encourage you to listen to your own body. And if something doesn't feel right, pick one of the options. Or just come into a yoga pose of your choosing and then jump back in whenever you're ready. So today's practice is a little balance and flow. So it will follow the usual kind of curve that I follow, beginning with a centering, working up to a little more strenuous activity, then ending up back on the mat. So just close your eyes and just focus on your body. Just come into the breath. Just mentally scan your body, note any areas of tightness, any limitations, and just be willing to work within those limitations. Be okay with how you feel at this moment. So we'll come into the Ujjayi breath today. But first, I want you to think about softening your belly and just allowing it to expand with your inhale. And as you exhale, just drawing belly button in towards spine, using those abdominal muscles to help expel all the breath. Inhaling, soften the belly, allow it to expand. Exhale, draw belly button in. If you can, try to inhale and exhale through the nose. And then if you would like to add the Ujjayi sound, you have to constrict your throat slightly so that as you inhale and exhale, you can hear the air whispering up and down your throat. If you're unsure how to achieve this, just think about the feeling you would get in your throat if you were trying to fog up the bathroom mirror. Perhaps adding this slight restriction has now caused you to inhale and exhale a little more slowly, a little more controlled. Just follow the path of the air as it moves in and out of the lungs, just focusing on the soft whispering sound as the breath moves. Taking one more full slow breath. Just allow the breath to be natural without thinking about it too much. You can keep that soft Ujjayi sound or not. Personal preference. And if your eyes were closed, just softly open them. Just begin coming into turtle. It's a little bit of a hip opener. So it's kind of like bound angle. Soles of your feet are together and your knees are kind of falling outward. But I want you to push your feet a little further forward. Push them towards the front of your mat. And then just kind of lean forward here on the sit bones, keeping a tall, straight spine. And Perhaps you'll find you can lean forward a little more while maintaining that long, straight spine. And you'll just reach a point where you know if you go any further forward, you'll have to round your spine. So you have a choice to stay here with a straight spine or just allow the spine to round, bringing nose towards your feet or towards the floor. You can even bring your arms underneath your legs, palms down. Perhaps even bring the palms of the hands to the tops of the feet. Just breathing into the back side of the body, allowing full expansion as you inhale. Release with the exhale. Take one more breath here, and then use your next inhale to release the arms and bring the spine back up nice and tall. Take your hands behind you, just to a comfortable position, and just draw your shoulder blades together to expand and open up the chest for seated fish. This is a slight back bend and a chest opener. You can keep your gaze straight forward or turn the head to look up if that's comfortable. Go ahead and release that, bringing the arms by your sides. I'm just going to turn on the mat. So make sure you're long ways on your mat and just extend your feet forward, coming into Dandasana or staff pose. So again, you're kind of nestled onto your sit bones. Spine is long and tall. Your arms are just resting by your side with the palms flat on the mat. Your feet are flexed. Take a couple of breaths here. Core should be engaged to help keep the spine nice and long. So we'll be adding a spinal twist here, so keeping the right leg long, just draw your left leg in. Option to keep the foot on the inside of this right leg or just cross it over. Bringing the foot to the outside of the leg, keeping this front foot flexed, keeping the spine tall. Take an inhale breath. And with an exhale, twist towards your left. And you can use your right arm to just kind of hug the left knee towards you, aiding the twist, or maybe take it to the outside of your thigh and kind of press against your thigh, pushing yourself a little deeper into this twist. If it's comfortable, you can turn your head and look back. Just slowly release the twist, keeping the legs as they are. Just twist your upper body the opposite way again, keeping a nice tall spine. Finding that counter twist. And just go ahead and release that twist, extend your left leg long. Make sure again you're nice and tall, then draw the right knee in, perhaps bringing it over to the outside of the left leg. Left foot is flexed, spine is long. Take an inhale breath, and as you exhale, begin to twist from the waist up towards the right side. One more inhale breath, exhale, really ring out the spine. Inhale, and as you exhale, find that counter twist. Gradually release this twist and slowly make your way onto hands and knees, finding a tabletop position, making sure joints are stacked in the arms and legs, hands are spread nice and wide. And just loosening up the spine a little more here with some cat dog or cat cow. So on your inhale, belly lowers, tailbone and chin tip up. And as you exhale, rounding the spine, drawing belly button in, and tucking chin and tailbone. Just flowing back and forth from one posture to the other, working with the rhythm of your own breath. Take one more inhale breath. Exhale, really round the back, draw in the belly button, pushing into hands and knees. And then come to a neutral spine. Then keeping your right knee grounded, extend your left leg straight back. You want to keep it about at hip height and flex the foot. And if you want, you can also release the right arm, reaching it forward. Keep your palm facing inward as you reach that arm forward, pushing through the heel, reaching through the fingertips, drawing belly button in. It's a little balance here, a little core work. Inhale. As you exhale, just lower the hand to the mat and then cross your leg behind you, bringing the foot over to the right side. And then just turn and look back at that foot, creating a little C curve in your spine. And then gradually coming back to your tabletop. Extend your right leg back, flexing the foot, pushing through the heel. Perhaps leaning slightly forward here onto the arms, and then maybe extending the opposite arm, that left arm forward, reaching through the fingertips, palm facing towards the right, drawing belly button up and in. Building a little heat here. Strangers in some place, just trying to get home. You are the only thing. Take one more inhale breath. As you exhale, lower the hand to the mat and cross that right leg behind you towards the left. And just kind of turn and look back towards that foot. Slowly return your knees to the mat. Take your hands a little forward of the shoulders. Perhaps bring your toes together and we'll sink the hips back, coming into child's pose. So just make sure you bring the head down to rest on something. If it doesn't comfortably rest on your mat, make a fist with one of your hands to support your head. Breathe into the back of the body here. Allow the upper back to fully expand with each inhale. If you would like to add a twist here, keep your left hand grounded. Take your right hand, flip it palm up, and then thread it under the left and reach out towards the left side, coming into a thread the needle arm. Again, resting your head either on the mat or make a fist with your left hand to support the head. Releasing that arm, extending it forward, picking up the left hand, flipping it palm up, and threading those fingertips out to the right, bringing that shoulder and the head down to the mat, finding your spinal twist. And my believer night, I'm glad to meet you. And releasing this arm, extending both hands forward, spreading the fingers nice and wide. Make your way onto hands and knees, draw belly button up and in, hook your toes under. Just begin lifting up the hips here for downward facing dog. Pushing into your hands here to kind of push your chest back towards your thighs. Pushing heels down in the general direction of the floor. It's not necessary that they touch the floor. Tipping tailbone up and back slightly. And drawing shoulder blades down your back and then wrapping them forward. Finding support for the spine as we hold this downward dog. Staying right here, or maybe coming up onto the balls of the feet and alternately pushing one heel then the other down into the mat, walking out your dog. Coming to stillness, taking a breath here, and then slowly walking the feet forward towards the front of your mat and landing in a forward fold. Then bringing hands to shins or thighs, inhaling, come about halfway up, finding jackknife. Knees are soft, crown of the head is pointing forward, shoulder blades are being used to draw your shoulders back away from the ears. Spine is parallel with the floor. We'll be coming to standing, so soften the knees and with an inhale breath, reaching the arms out and up, reach up nice and tall into extended mountain, and then draw hands to heart. So we'll be coming into a flow here. We'll be doing some half sun salutations, and then moving into three full rounds of sun salutation A and three rounds of sun salutation B. So just stand with hands to heart, feet are parallel and about hip width. Make sure you kind of join the inner arches of the feet up. Your leg muscles are engaged, glutes are engaged, pelvis is slightly forward, core is in, palms are pushing together. There's a lot going on here. Inhale, reach up tall. Exhale with soft knees, dive forward. Inhale halfway. Exhale fold. Inhale, sweeping arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, extended mountain. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweeping arms out and up, reaching tall. Exhale, hands to heart. One more round before we add on. Dive forward. Inhale, jackknife. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweeping arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart, adding on. Inhale, reach. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, jackknife. Exhale, fold. Inhale, finding plank. Or your option is knees down in a tabletop. Exhale, shift forward, lower down, coming to plank. Hover, hover, or lower all the way down. Inhale, finding upward dog or cobra. Exhale, downward dog. We'll stay here for a breath. Inhale, soften knees and look forward. Exhale, walk towards the front of your mat. Inhale, jackknife. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweeping arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart, flowing through two more of those. Making your way to plank or tabletop. Exhale, lower. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Stay here for a breath. Softening knees, look forward. Exhale, make your way towards the front of your mat. Inhale, jackknife. Exhale, fold. Inhale, softening knees, sweep arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart. One more on your own. I'll try not to say too much. Just work with your breath, linking breath and movement. Make sure you pause for a breath once you reach downward dog. Inhale, reaching up, exhale, hands to heart. So adding on for sun salutation B, inhale, reach up. Exhale, soften your knees, coming to chair pose. Inhale here. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Stepping back to plank or tabletop on an inhale. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Soften your knees. Step your left foot forward. Set your heel down. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, come down to runner's lunge. Stepping back to plank. Inhale, exhale, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Soften your knees, step right foot forward. Set your heel. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, releasing back down, stepping back to plank on your inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Pause for a breath. Soften your knees, look forward. Make your way to the front of the mat. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, find the chest, so sinking your hips down, reaching up. Exhale, right here. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, sink into chair. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Come to jackknife. Fold. Find your plank or tabletop. And lower down. Coming to cobra or upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Softening your knees. Step left foot forward, set your heel, inhale, warrior one. Exhale, release. Stepping back to plank on an inhale, exhale, lower. Upward dog, downward dog. Softening knees, right foot steps forward, set your heel, inhale, reaching up. Exhale, release down, step back to plank. Exhale, lower. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Stay here for a breath. Soften your knees and look forward. Make your way to the front of the mat. Inhale, jackknife. Exhale, fold. Finding that chair pose on an inhale. Exhale, right here. Inhale, come up tall. Exhale, hands to heart. Last one. Inhale, reach. Exhale, chair. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, jackknife. Exhale, fold. Finding plank or tabletop. Exhale, lower. Come into upward facing dog. Downward dog. Soften knees. Left foot steps forward. Set your heel. Inhale, brings you up to warrior one. Exhale, release. Step back to plank. Exhale, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Bring your right foot forward, set your heel. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, release down. Inhale, plank. Lower down. Look to upward facing dog. Exhale, downward dog. Pause here. We'll take one more breath here. Soften your knees and look forward. Come to the front of your mat. Inhale, jackknife. Exhale, fold. Lowering the hips. Inhale, finding chair. Exhale here. Inhale, come up tall. Exhale, hands to heart. Hallelujah. We're done with our flow. Just take a moment to stand in mountain pose, hands in Anjali Mudra, with thumbs against chest. You probably built some heat, feeling your heart beating a little quicker. Woo. So we'll be coming into some standing postures and incorporating a few balances into those. So making sure you're at the front of your mat. Keep your right foot forward, step your left foot back. Set your heel down. Inhaling, finding warrior one. And so just make sure that your front knee doesn't extend beyond your toes. Back leg is straight, hips are facing front. Take an inhale breath here, and as you exhale, let's open up to warrior two. So now hips are facing the side. Again, knee has a generous bend in the front leg, back leg is straight, arms reaching out. Fingertips spread wide. Straightening your front leg. Just beginning to lean forward like you're reaching out for something and then windmill your arms, finding triangle. So you can reach all the way down to the floor or maybe place the front hand on your shin. Keep the knees soft. And just keep this top shoulder open and back. Gaze can be up, straight ahead, or down towards the floor. Personal preference. Use your next inhale breath to bring you back up, bending the knee, finding warrior two briefly. And keeping the front knee bent this time, lean forward, bring your elbow to thigh. and sweep this back arm overhead, making sure this hip stays down. So you've kind of got a diagonal line from the back leg all the way up to this top arm. So from here, we'll be adding our first balance, coming into balancing half moon. So I'm actually just going to shift back a little bit so you can see better. So kind of shift your back foot forward to get your front fingertips down. Then begin to straighten this front leg. So your back leg will lift off the floor if it helps bring hand to hip. And this back leg can stay here, or you can elevate your back leg off again, just whatever feels comfortable. I would recommend for now just keeping your gaze kind of down at the mat. And you can keep this top arm on your hip, or just reach that arm up so you kind of have a straight line from your bottom arm to your top arm. It's a very challenging posture. It's always a work in progress, so don't sweat it, don't worry about it. Just keep trying, come in and out of it as many times as you need. Just slowly bend that front knee. Set your back knee back down, coming briefly to warrior two. And then we'll release the back heel and turn to face the front of your mat, the short edge. Coming into, almost fell. Coming into crescent lunge, which is also a balance because your back heel is lifted. And from here, coming to warrior three. Straighten your front leg, come onto the tiptoe of that back foot. Maybe bringing hands by your side. Lift the back toes off the floor. Feel free to stay here. Or just being mindful to keep this left hip down. Just begin to tip at the hip. So you want to avoid kind of opening up and hiking this left hip up. Keep the front knee slightly soft. You can point or flex the back foot. Hands can stay on your hip. They can open up for airplane. They can reach back. They can reach forward. Take one more breath. Make your way upright and step that left foot behind the right, reaching up. Just grab hold of your left wrist with your right hand. Inhale. And as you exhale, find a little bit of an arch to the side. So you're coming into kind of a crescent moon shape. And then release the arms, exhale, fold forward. And then slowly roll up, uncross your legs, shake your legs out. We'll move through that with the opposite foot in front, so keeping your left foot at the top of your mat. Step back with your right foot. Arms can come up, reaching up for warrior one. And then opening up to warrior two, sinking into that front knee. Arms are at shoulder height, energy radiating from fingertips to fingertips. Straightening your front knee. Go ahead and lean forward like you're reaching for something, and then windmill the arms, finding triangle. Then just be mindful to keep this top shoulder open and there. And then using your back arm to pull you up, bending into that front knee. So you're coming back to your warrior two. We'll bring the elbow to knee and find your extended side angle. So we'll be coming into that balancing half moon. So just make sure you bring your back leg in a little bit so you can get your fingertips down, maybe a foot or two in front of that front leg. And just begin to straighten your front leg and lift your back leg to your own degree. Hand can remain on your hip, or you can open the hand up. Don't be afraid to try, don't be afraid to fail. No one's watching. You can always practice this on your own if it's something you aspire to. slowly bending your front knee, setting back foot down. Finding warrior two. I'm coming into that crescent lunge. So pivoting on your back foot, lifting the heel, sinking down into the hips, reaching up. And then coming onto the front leg and making your way into your version of warrior three, just being mindful not to hike that right hip up. Keep your hips level with the mat. And then as you make your way upright, just bringing this right leg behind the left, reaching up with an inhale, grabbing right wrist. On an exhale, arch to the left side. Inhale and reach up tall, soften your knees, exhale, fold forward. You can stop here in kind of a cross-legged jackknife, or you can make your way all the way forward here. And then rolling on up, uncross your legs, give your legs a shake. We have a little more balancing to do. We'll be coming into eagle, and from there coming into a star pose, and then a knee balance. So let's set your left foot down into the mat, sink down into that leg, cross your right foot over the left, and place the ball of the foot down. So we'll work on the arms first, bring the arms in front of you, and we'll cross the right arm under the left, and just try to hook your forearms around each other and bring palms together. If that doesn't work, backs of hands can come together, or you can just hug your shoulders. Lift the elbows up just a little bit and try to sink a little more into the legs. And from here, if you want, you can lift up this right foot, maybe even trying to hook it around the left leg. Squeezing your legs together, sinking into your legs. Trying not to lean too far forward. Core is tight, pull your belly button in. Then from here, release the arms, release the leg, and find your star pose. Open up here. Reach out, spread the fingertips. You can flex that right foot or point the toes. And then from here, just bring your knee in front of you and reach up, finding a knee balance. Reaching tall, looking up if you want a bit more challenge. Then release your arms, release the foot. And just go ahead and shake your legs. Come, bring feet about hip width apart. Just come into some hip circles here. Keep the knees soft. Just kind of releasing the low back. It does tend to tighten up when we balance. Maybe pausing and taking those hips in the opposite direction. And then sinking into your right leg. Cross your left leg over. Keep the ball of the foot down. Bring arms out in front. This time you'll be taking left arm under right. Twizzling your arms around and trying to bring palms together. Sink into the legs. Then if you want, pick up this left foot. Maybe even wrap it around your right leg. Core is tight. Find a stable focal point. Squeezing legs together, maybe raising your elbows an inch higher. Sinking your hips an inch lower. One more breath, release the arms, release the left leg, open up, finding a star pose, reaching tall, shining out, energy radiating from the fingertips, through this left leg, through the heel or through the pointed toe. And then reaching up, bringing your knee in front of you for a knee balance. If you want the added challenge, just look up. And then bring this foot down, bringing arms down. Again, just give your legs a bit of a shake. So we'll be coming into a squat here. So you can either take a pretty wide stance and just come down till your thighs are, you know, approximately level to the mat or a little higher. You can work on your squat here, maybe kind of rocking from side to side or perhaps leaning forward a little, dipping one shoulder and then the other. If you prefer a full, deeper squat, bring your feet in a little bit and squat all the way down here, keeping heels down. So if you can't keep your heels down, pick the other squat. I want you to bring your elbows against your inside of your knees and kind of push out so your thighs open a little bit. Press through the palms of the hands and try to keep your spine straight and tall. Now we can stay here just working on the squat, allowing this stretch to happen. If crow is in your practice, the arm balance, I would invite you to try that now. If you don't regularly practice crow, I would not recommend trying it right now. I would try it, make sure you have a bunch of pillows or cushions in front of your head, just in case you do pitch forward. So I'm going to turn to the side. Just to show you the crow, you would bring your palms down, come up onto your toes a little bit, maybe bring your feet in a little bit more, and then just begin to lift the feet up, drawing the belly button up and in. You do need good core strength, good upper body strength for a crow. If you do want to practice this later on, I would definitely recommend putting pillows or cushions in front. And just kind of bringing your weight onto your arms whilst leaving the feet down. And then maybe just lifting one foot, place it down, lift the other. Kind of practice that way before you try the full crow. If you are in crow, just come back to your squat. We'll just take another breath or two in our squat. So if you're in the high squat, we will be making our way to having a seat on the mat from here. So if you're in the high squat, just kind of bend your legs and find a seat. If you're in the low squat, you're practically sitting anyway. So just come to somewhere in the center of your mat. If you need help laying down, you need help with the core, pull behind your legs. If you want to challenge the pull, keep your arms out and just very slowly just make your way down. Take a few breaths. Once you get down, come into a full body stretch. Reaching fingers overhead, flexing your feet, pushing through the heels. Another breath here, and then we'll sweep our arms down by our side. We're coming into Matsyasana or the fish. This is a back bend. So arms by your side, palms down, and then you'll want to kind of rock a bit from side to side here, and as you do so, work your hands underneath your glutes. So you'll be obviously laying down, but it's like you're sitting on your hands. Flex your feet. From here, you'll begin to bend the elbows so that your back arches off the mat. What you want to do is try to kind of drag your head in so that you maintain connection on the mat with your head. You don't want to be hovering the head off the floor. So come up onto the forearms and kind of rest your head. I'm kind of resting on my bun, but otherwise your head should be down on the mat. Feet are flexed, belly's drawing in. And the tears come streaming down your face. Take one more breath. And then go ahead and release the pose, release your arms, and just draw your knees in. Be gentle because this is creating a rounding of the spine, which is opposite to the back bend we just did. And once you've got your knees in comfortably, just kind of rock side to side here. And then pausing here, extend your legs up and flex your feet. So you're in hip stand or legs against the wall pose. Option to stay here, point and flex your feet, circle the ankles, bend your knees one at a time. Maybe bring the arms up, give everything a shake. If you have half shoulder stand in your practice, you'll lift your hips up, bringing the palms of the hands behind your hips for support. And legs are slightly angled back, feet are flexed. And you have the same options, pointing and flexing the feet or circling out the ankles, perhaps bending your knees. If you are in this half shoulder stand, you also have the option of plow. This adds a little compression to your thyroid gland. So you would allow the feet to kind of come towards the floor behind you, overhead. If you are in plow or hip stand, just gently release, bringing your hips back down to the mat. I should have said half shoulder stand. So we're returning to hip stand. And from here, bend your knees. Either grab the insteps of your feet, grab your shins, or maybe just rest legs on back of thighs and interlace the fingers. Coming into happy baby. And just make sure once you're holding your legs in the desired spot that you bring your tailbone back down to the mat. You don't want to be rounded up. You want to lower your tailbone back down. And then you can begin to rock side to side if that feels good. If you want to work on your hamstrings a little bit, you can bend and straighten the legs. Letting go of your feet, bringing feet flat on the mat. We're working into the hips a little bit more with a figure four stretch. So keeping left foot grounded, bring the right ankle just below the left knee. Connect low back to mat and use your hand to kind of push this right knee a little further away. So this may be enough right here. If you want a little more, you'll pick up the left foot and draw the left knee in. At the same time, try to kind of guide the right knee out. You also have the option of taking your right hand through the shins and interlacing your fingers on top of the left shin or behind the thigh. And then kind of draw that knee in and release a couple times. So you will feel a good sensation in your right hip. Think about sending the breath there. The visual helps the area relax, release. Whenever you're ready, draw the knee in and just pause. Just find a good stretch where you feel a little challenged, but you're not uncomfortable. It's kind of a balance between comfort and discomfort, or effort and ease. So find that balance point. And as you hold and breathe, you may find that you can work a little deeper into the posture with every few breaths. Take one more breath, and then slowly lower that foot back down to the mat. And then just close the gap between your knees here. Bring arms out to shoulder height. And then take a moment to shift your hips just a couple of inches to the right. And then begin to lower the knees over, across, and down towards the left side. And it's important to be mindful of the low back here. If low back is tight, you'll want to keep knee and hip in line with one another. If you have more flexibility, you can use your left hand to kind of guide this knee a little closer to the floor. So just listen to your body. Pay attention to what it's asking for. Try to keep your right shoulder connected to the floor as an anchor. Gaze can be straight up at the ceiling, or you can turn the head and look out towards your right hand. Just take one more breath here. And just make your way onto your back, uncross your legs, level off your hips. Just take a moment to allow those knees to fall gently from side to side. Coming to stillness, keeping your right foot grounded, bring your left ankle, place it just below the right knee, connecting low back to mat. Just gently ease this left knee away. And feel free to stay here, or pick up your right foot and draw the right knee in. You should feel a pretty good bullseye of sensation in the left hip. Perhaps threading your left hand under your shin and interlacing fingers on top of right shin, or grabbing behind the thigh. Okay, just take a moment or two to draw your knee in and release a couple times, just noting the sensation in your left hip. And the next time you draw your knee in, just hold there. Make it a little challenging, but comfortable. And just lay and breathe. Focus on that bullseye sensation. Think about sending your breath there, letting that area relax, release. Slowly releasing, bringing right foot down to the mat. close the gap between your knees, shift your hips an inch or two to the left, and bring the knees over, across and down to the right. Arms can be out at shoulder height. If you have more flexibility in your low back, you can take your right hand onto your knee. Just ease that knee a little closer to the floor, trying to keep the left shoulder connected to the mat. And just lay here. Gaze can be straight up at the ceiling or out towards your left hand. Just slowly make your way onto your back, uncross your legs. Okay, just take a moment here to allow knees to fall from side to side. We will be coming into Shavasana, our restore pose. So if you need to put on socks or a sweatshirt or grab a blanket, now would be a good time. Slowly make your way to a comfortable position. So if you're laying on your back, but you have, you know, a tight low back, keep your legs bent, feet flat on the floor. Just allow knees to fall in and support one another. Or perhaps you extend legs long, maybe even take them out to the corners of your mat. Arms by your side. Just kind of let the arms and legs gently roll out to the side. Or perhaps you're more comfortable laying on one side. And once you find that comfortable position, just again mentally scan the body. And just note any areas where you may still be holding on to tension. Try to relax, release, let go. Perhaps just gently rock your head from side to side. Just finding a comfortable place to rest the head. And just paying attention to where you feel the support of the floor beneath you. Take an inhale breath. And as you exhale, just surrender into the support of the earth. Allow it to support you, hold you up, to cradle you. Limbs are heavy. Muscles are soft. Breathing is natural. And try to keep the mind quiet. And just take the next few minutes just to relax, let go. Just tying the practice together.
Namah Shivaya.
begin to make some small movements, bringing your attention back to the present moment, taking in the sounds around you, perhaps noting how the air feels on your skin. Perhaps rolling onto one side and taking a few breaths there. Calm down eventually.
Calm down. Calm down.
Maintain that sense of calm that we cultivated during Shavasana. Slowly make your way to a seated position.
I am protected.
You just sit with the eyes gently closed, taking a few breaths here. Perhaps softly opening the eyes, take an inhale breath, reaching the arms out and up, bringing palms together and drawing hands towards your heart center. The light in me honors the light in you. Namaste.